This week's program contains two works, both by incredible masters of their craft, Wolfgang Mozart and Gustav Mahler. Mahler is represented by his Fifth Symphony, the one that actually was the change in Mahler's life, the first four having been related to songs and texts that had happened in earlier pieces. The Fifth is a pure instrumental work. There are no references to folk music, no references to the great Wunderhorn cycles that he wrote. It opens with a trumpet intoning a fanfare, as if it was at a funeral march, and this motive will be heard many times throughout the symphony. The scherzo features an amazing horn solo. The symphony is perhaps best known to some listeners for its famed adagietto, the fourth movement, or the beginning of the third part. It's been used in films, and there has been much controversy over how fast it should go, adagietto, after all. Probably means little adagio, but on the other hand, Mahler says, very slow. I will wait until you all arrive at the hall to see what tempo I choose to take. There's a circusy finale, which quotes various elements of the first four movements, and I think for a lot of people, this is one of the first Mahler symphonies that they come to. One, two, sometimes four and five. The other symphonies usually take a bit of time and an understanding of Mahler's language to grasp, but I'm very happy to be presenting it this time. Our soloist is the very distinguished pianist and my very good friend, Emanuel. We've known each other since school days at Juilliard. He joins us for the big E-flat concerto by Mozart. Manny is not a specialist. He plays repertoire from the Baroque right through to the latest music. But Mozart is something that he's particularly associated with, and it will be really a pleasure to welcome him to our stage.